Hello friends, this video on NEET Digestion and Absorption is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exam. Question number 21. Which enzyme initiates the digestion of proteins? So initiation is obviously done by pepsin. And then, so basically what happens is in the stomach, when hydrochloric acid is released, the medium becomes acidic, pH becomes optimum. So pepsin is activated from pepsinogen. Now, this pepsin, what it does is it converts proteins into proteases, right? So basically, it converts proteins into proteases, peptones, and large polypeptides. Now, there are other enzymes like trypsin, which converts these proteases, peptones, or large polypeptides into smaller peptides and amino acids. Right? So trypsin basically does a different function altogether. So trypsin acts on these proteases, peptones, and large polypeptides and convert them into smaller polypeptides, smaller peptides rather, and also amino acids. If you look at option C, aminopeptidase. So this is basically an enzyme. So this is an enzyme that catalyzes the cleavage of amino acids. So that's the purpose of aminopeptidase. And if you look at the last option, that is carboxypeptidase, that is another enzyme which helps in conversion of smaller peptides into amino acids. So you see, all of these somewhere or the other help in the digestion of proteins, but they have different roles. So when you talk about the enzyme which initiates the process, it is pepsin. Question number 22, which is incorrectly matched? Renin, liver, tylin, mouth, pepsin, stomach, trypsin, intestine. So basically, these are the name of the enzymes and these are the locations where they act. So here, the incorrect option is A. Because renin is present in stomach of infants and is produced in stomach. So that means their area of action is stomach. Besides that, all of them are correct. Tylin is nothing but salivary amylase. Pepsin, it is secreted by the gastric glands in stomach. And trypsin, again, is in the intestine, which is secreted by the pancreas. So pepsin and trypsin, they help in digestion of proteins. And tylin helps in digestion of carbohydrates. Question number 23, pernicious anemia results due to deficiency of vitamin B1, B12, vitamin A or iron. So the correct option is B, that is vitamin B12. Now quickly look at the other options. The deficiency of vitamin B1 can cause diseases like beriberi or loss of appetite, which is known as anorexia. So where you don't feel hungry at all. So that happens due to deficiency of B1. Deficiency of vitamin A can cause night blindness, which is a very common disorder due to deficiency of vitamin A. It can also cause several skin diseases, so dermatosis. So vitamin A is very important for good skin. Deficiency of iron can cause anemia. Question number 24. Absorption of vitamin B12 in human requires P glycoprotein secreted from Q. The correct choices of P and Q are. So, vitamin B12 is commonly known as the extrinsic factor, right? And in order to absorb vitamin B12, what is needed is an intrinsic factor. And who secretes that intrinsic factor? So the stomach, you remember the parietal cells in the stomach, which secretes the hydrochloric acid. So along with hydrochloric acid, they also secrete a glycoprotein called intrinsic factor. And this intrinsic factor is necessary for the absorption of extrinsic factor, that is vitamin B12. Easy way to remember, vitamin B12 is also called extrinsic factor. To absorb extrinsic factor, we need intrinsic factor. So the correct option is the one with intrinsic factor, and where from where is the intrinsic factor secreted? From the stomach. So correct option is B. So here you have a new, so obviously extrinsic factor is not correct because extrinsic factor is nothing but vitamin B12. Exopolysaccharides, what are they? So these are basically high molecular weight polymers which are composed of sugar residues. Now, firstly, these are not secreted by stomach. These are secreted by microorganisms into the surrounding environment. So that's about these exopolysaccharides. Let's look at question number 25. Choose the correct option. Vitamin B3, biotin, which is not correct because vitamin B3 is niacin. So A is the incorrect option. Other than that, all are correct. So B10 is called folic acid, B12 is pangamic acid, vitamin E is tocopherol. So see, these names are very important. So it is better that when you study, when you are trying to revise the lesson on digestion and absorption, make a list of all these names so that, you know, you can just quickly revise that before the day of your exam. And okay, for your information, what is biotin? So biotin is basically B7. B7 is biotin. Niacin is also called nicotinic acid. Question number 26, which of the following does not produce an enzyme? Salivary gland produces salivary amylase, so this is not the right option. Pancreas, it produces pancreatic lipase, which includes trypsin, chymotrypsin, amylopectin, and they all help in the digestion of proteins and even lipids. Liver, liver produces bile juice, but that is not an enzyme, right? So therefore, liver is the right option. So here again, we have written down the same thing. Salivary glands produces ghrelin. Stomach secretes pepsin, renin, gastric lipase, gastric amylase. Pancreas, amylopectin, trypsin, chymotrypsin, and so on. Question number 27. In the following process of digestion of proteins in the stomach, the enzymes at location X and Y are respectively proteins to protease and peptones, from there to dipeptides. So we... Sometime back, we discussed about the digestion of proteins. So the initiation of digestion of protein happens with pepsin. So this X is nothing but pepsin. That means the correct option is B. And what is Y? The next stage is trypsin, because trypsin converts the proteases and peptones into dipeptides. Now, what about the other options which are seen here? For example, chymotrypsin. What does chymotrypsin do? So, chymotrypsin acts on proteins, proteases, peptones, and large peptides and convert them into smaller peptides. So, like how trypsin is converting them into dipeptides, chymotrypsin will further convert them into smaller peptides. If you talk about the dipeptidase, what is dipeptidase? So dipeptidase helps in conversion of dipeptides into amino acids. In fact, these are enzymes. So dipeptidases are enzymes. And what do? They help in conversion of these dipeptides into amino acids. So again, a quick recap. In stomach, pepsin acts on proteins initially and convert them into protease and peptones. Trypsin then acts on protease and peptones and convert them into dipeptides. Question number 28. Match the following columns and choose the correct option. So again, you see the names. Just now I was telling you, you should know the names. What is called what? For example, folic acid is called vitamin B10. So C will be mapped to 3. So if you look at the options here, so B and D are ruled out. So you are left with A or C. Now you have to find out which is correct. Again, if you look at tocopherol, so tocopherol is vitamin E. So that means B will be mapped to 2. But if you see in both of these options, A and C, B is mapped to 2. Right? So we need to find out more. Now let us look at maybe cobalamin. So what is cobalamin? It is vitamin B12. That means A should map to 1. So here the correct option would be A. So this is the correct mapping. Vitamin B12 is called cobalamin. Vitamin E is tocopherol. B10 is folic acid. B3 is cholecalciferol. And vitamin K is phylloquinone. In fact, as you are going through this video on the MCQs, please make a note of these names and make a note of these names at one place so that that acts as your revision notes later. Question number 29. Hormone X is secreted by islets of Langerhans and inhibits secretion of insulin and glucagon. So we have to tell what is this hormone X? Which is this hormone which is secreted by islets of Langerhans and it also inhibits the secretion of insulin and glucagon. So the correct option is somatostatin. So the somatostatin actually, you know, kind of maintains the level of insulin and glucagon in the blood. Let us also talk about the other three options that are given here. So if we talk about secretin, so secretin is secreted by the duodenal epithelium. That means the epithelium of the duodenum. So it is secreted by the duodenal epithelium. And what does it do? It stimulates the release of digestive enzymes. So I think we can write it here. It stimulates release of digestive enzymes. If you look at option B, duocrinin. So duo, again, from duodenum. So duocrinin is also released by the duodenal epithelium. And what does it do? It stimulates the Bruner's gland to release mucus. So it stimulates mucus release. Then we have villikainin. So villikainin is secreted by the small intestine. In small intestine, you have villi, which helps in better absorption. So from there only the name villikainin. So it is secreted by small intestine. And what does it do? It accelerates the movement of villi. Accelerates movement of villi. So you see, there is a lot in the name. So even if you observe the name very carefully, you get a hint from where it is secreted or what does it do. So here we found that somatostatin is released by the delta cells of islets of Langerhans of pancreas and they inhibit the secretion of insulin and glucagon. It also inhibits the absorption of nutrients from the gastrointestinal tract. So that's about somatostatin. Question number 30. Surplus carbohydrates are stored in our body as fats. So that is why surplus means excess, extra. So when we eat carbohydrates in various forms, whatever is needed by the body will be utilized. But whatever extra carbohydrates gets accumulated in the body, they would be stored as fats. And therefore, if you end up overeating, excessive eating can make you really fat and can even lead to a condition called obesity. So surplus carbohydrates converted into fats and this process is called lipogenesis. That is formation of fats. Genesis means formation. Lipo is related to lipids. So they are converted into fats and glycogen and these are stored in liver and muscles. So the fats in your muscles can be seen very evidently. Now, normally a daily requirement of carbohydrates in any adult is about 500 grams. So anything that you are taking beyond 500 grams is going to be stored in your body as fats.
Thank you. Please visit examfear.com for free quality education. You can learn with a simple four-step learning process wherein you can watch video lessons, you can ask your questions, you can refer notes, and you can take a free online test. We have content for class 6 to 12 on physics, chemistry, mathematics, and biology along with practical videos. So please subscribe to our channel for daily updates. Thank you.